Good morning, friends. Today we would be starting with Indian efforts to conserve biodiversity. Now, in this, there are many acts, programs that we want to cover, but today we are starting with Wildlife Protection Act. We have talked about wildlife protection a lot while we were doing various species of animals which are critically endangered, endangered, and so on, and we had seen that many of those critically endangered species were there in Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act. So now, today, we want to look at what this Wildlife Protection Act is, what are various dimensions associated with Wildlife Protection Act, and under Wildlife Protection Act is defined national park, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserve, community reserve, and so on. And therefore, we would also, after completing Wildlife Protection Act, we would jump onto various national parks in the country. Tomorrow, I'll be keeping an extra class. I have requested the admin here to provide me a slot for an extra class where we'll continue with today's class only. Tomorrow, we'll try to finish the pen. So today, we'll be dealing with national parks which are there in North India and Northeast India. Tomorrow, we'll cover Central India, West India, Central India, and South India, rest of the wildlife sanctuaries. So this class would be in two parts. Tomorrow, there would be an extra class. Okay, now, so let us start with Wildlife Protection Act, the first Indian effort that we want to talk about.
So, sorry to disturb you, sir, but there is a lag, audio lag.
यार ऑडियो लाइक सबको हो रहा है क्या नहीं सबको नहीं हो रहा सबको नहीं हो रहा है तो देयर मस्ट बी समथिंग फ्रॉम योर इंटरनेट समथिंग लाइक दैट गाइस
स्टार्ट कर लिया मैंने
ओके ओके चलिए तो वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट से शुरू कर रहे हैं नाउ लुक एट द नेम ऑफ द एक्ट नेम वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन इट विल टेल यू द पर्पस ओवरऑल look after wildlife in the country. So if we have to protect wildlife, what we'll do? We'll first define what wildlife is. Then we'll say, what are the things that can be done with wildlife? What are the things that cannot be done with wildlife? We have already said, under this act, we also have various protected areas, like national park, wildlife sanctuaries, tiger reserves. There are various statutory bodies, for example, National Tiger Conservation Authority, और नेशनल वाइल्ड लाइफ बोर्ड ऑल दोस थिंग्स हैव बीन डन अंडर दिस एक्ट गाइस आप लोग सब अपने आप को म्यूट पे रखिए कुछ लोग म्यूट पे नहीं है जिस वजह से नाउ कमिंग टू व्हाट इज वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट एन एक्ट टू प्रोटेक्ट वाइल्ड लाइफ हाउ इज इट डूइंग इट फर्स्ट इट इज डिफाइनिंग व्हाट वाइल्ड लाइफ इज नाउ इट हैज डिफाइंड वाइल्ड लाइफ इन अ वेरी ब्रॉडर मैनर वाइल्ड लाइफ आर नॉट ओनली द मैमेलियन एनिमल्स व्हिच आर देयर वाइल्ड लाइफ is not only the plants which are there. You will see wildlife includes animals, bees, butterflies, crustaceans, fish, moths, aquatic or land vegetation, which form part of any habitat. So it has defined wildlife in a very broad manner. Then this act, along with the provisions of this act, along with the wildlife protection rule, basically is the core set of rules in the country which is working towards wildlife protection. So under this act, we create five different types of protected areas. We have national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, community reserves, conservation reserves, and tiger reserves. All these five things would be done by tomorrow's class. We'll look at all these five things. Today, we'll be starting with national parks. So basically, it's national park, wildlife sanctuaries, community reserve, and conservation reserve we will study separately, but tiger reserves are generally either also national park or wildlife sanctuary. So when we are studying various national park, for example, today when we'll study Corbett National Park, there we'll also study the fact that it's a tiger reserve. When we'll study Rajaji National Park, when we'll study Dudhwa National Park, we'll also study that these are all tiger reserves. So tiger reserves, we will not study separately. We have already studied about National Tiger Conservation Authority. We have already studied about a tiger census. We have done all those things. So tiger reserve, yeah, specially alag se nahi padte. Okay. So these five kinds of protected areas are defined under Wildlife Protection Act. You may be asked a very simple question. In Indian laws, national park is covered under which of the following acts? Wildlife Protection Act, Environmental Protection Act, Air Pollution Act, Water Pollution Act. Usmein bhi aapko pata hona chahiye ki it is Wildlife Protection Act which is providing for these protected areas. See, Biosphere Reserve is something else. It comes under UNESCO's Man and Biosphere Program. It is not included here. Biosphere Reserve may have many national park, wildlife sanctuaries, tiger reserves, and so on. Okay, what is there? What are the five types of protected areas which are there in this? Are these five protected areas? Other than this, the Act says that hunting is not allowed. It prohibits hunting in the protected areas. It provides for protection and management of wildlife habitats. It provides for various types of protected areas. We've already looked at it. And an important point, this Act itself is providing for management of zoos. So in tomorrow's class, we'll also be talking about zoo, the Central Zoo Authority and various different zoos which were in news. Recently, some new zoo have been formed or have been announced. One has been announced in Gujarat where Reliance is planning to start world's largest zoo. So all those things would also be done here. Now, come to the important part, the sixth schedules of Wildlife Protection Act. We had seen tiger is in Schedule 1. It has been given highest protection that is available to any wildlife species in India. Elephant is in Schedule 1. Lion is in Schedule 1. So while doing that, I had just mentioned ki it means that under Indian laws, it has been provided highest protection. But now, clearly look at the different schedules and different kinds of protections which are available. So first is Schedule 1 and Part 2 of Schedule 2. We're discussing both these together, Schedule 1 and Part 2 of Schedule 2. Part 2 of Schedule 2 may we have a number of butterflies and so on. These are the schedules which have the highest level of protection. Punishment is very high. Even in extreme circumstances, hunting or killing of these animals or these things which are mentioned under the Schedule 1 and Part 2 of Schedule 2 would not be allowed. So when we were listing an animal in Schedule 1, we were saying that it has highest amount of protection. Like tomorrow, if tiger's population increase a lot in let's say Ranthambore Tiger Reserve, and tigers start killing people around, tigers start destroying villages, even then tigers cannot be declared vermin and are not allowed to be killed. Tigers, because they are in Schedule 1, or if something is in Part 2 of Schedule 2 also, they have highest type of protection. Okay, so they are not allowed to be declared vermin. Even vermin are those animals which we are allowed to kill. For example, crow is a vermin, mouse is a vermin. Aapke ghar mein chuha aa jata hai, aap maar dete ho, police will not arrest you because it's a vermin. But these species, they have highest level of protection, highest punishment, highest fine, plus they cannot be declared vermin. Then we have Schedule 3 and Schedule 4. Here animals have lesser amount of protection. Schedule 5 is that of vermin. Animals which can be hunted. Here we have common crow, fruit bat, mice, rats. These are animals which are allowed to be hunted. Then we have Schedule 6. In Schedule 6, we have some endemic plants. These plants are threatened. These plants have medicinal properties. These plants also have that aesthetic properties. So people tend to remove them from wild areas and plant them in their gardens. And therefore, government has identified 6 such endemic plants and have included it under Schedule 6. And it has been said that its cultivation and trade is prohibited, or it will be done in a very regulated manner. So, here we have 6 such endemic plants. Bedome, Skycat, Blue Vanda, Kut, Lady Slippers Orchids, Pitcher Plant, Red Vanda. These may be medicinal, of medicinal property. These may be of aesthetic property. These may be threatened. And thus, we are not allowed to remove them from the wild, buy them, cultivate them. It's prohibited. These plants are there in Schedule 6. So Schedule 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, highest amount of protection hai, 1 and Schedule 2, Part 2 mein, highest amount of protection, Schedule 3, 4, lesser protection, Schedule 5, vermin, you're allowed to hunt, and Schedule 6, some endemic, please remember, these are endemic plant species, which are not found at other places. These plant species have been included in Schedule 6 and their trade or cultivation is prohibited. Even cultivation is prohibited. So you cannot say that, dekho, maine, I took this pitcher plant and I have cultivated it in my garden. No, you're not allowed to do that. Okay, I hope the schedule thing, which we have been consistently speaking about from the very first class, is properly understood. Now, under Wildlife Protection Act only, has been created National Board for Wildlife. So, first thing that we should know is National Board for Wildlife is a statutory body. In exam, they'll ask you, the National Board of Wildlife, kis act ke andar hai, or is it an executive body, is it a statutory body? You should be able to answer that. Second thing that you should know is, it is headed by a Prime Minister. They may give you a statement, National Board of Wildlife is headed by Secretary of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, or Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. No, National Board of Wildlife is a statutory body which is headed by Prime Minister, and its vice chairperson is Minister of Environment. So, Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Then, what is its function? Its function is advisory first. It advises both center and state on policy decisions related to wildlife. For example, it will review wildlife related issues and approve projects in and around national parks and sanctuaries. Uske baad project approval aage jayega. Then boundaries of national park or wildlife sanctuaries, they cannot be reduced, changed without permission of National Board of Wildlife. So National Board of Wildlife, a statutory body headed by Prime Minister, Vice Chairperson, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, advises on both center and state. Please note, though it's National Board of Wildlife, it will advise both center and state on issues related to wildlife. It makes policies, it makes programs, it approves certain projects. All these things are being done by this body. In the same way, we have National Tiger Conservation Authority. NTCA we are not discussing here because we have already covered it while dealing with the tiger species. It's also a statutory body under Wildlife Protection Act. NTCA was added later, I think 2006 mein add hua hai, us time ko bhi add hua hai, by an amendment, but it's also a statutory body which has been created by Wildlife Protection. Then, now consider this scenario. One tiger enters your village and starts killing people. And it's not possible to capture it, to tranquilize it, or to translocate it. You're not able to do this. In this situation, you're allowed to hunt that animal, shoot that animal, kill that animal, after taking permission from Chief Wildlife Warden. So this has been provided under Section 11(1)(a) of the Act. What is it? Problematic wild animals only can be killed if they cannot be captured, tranquilized, or translocated. Okay, then we have some species can be declared vermin. For example, sometimes what happens is a nilgai, its population increases and it starts penetrating into agricultural areas. Or nilgai ko generally nahi kiya jata hai. Or let's say monkeys. Monkeys, their population increase and they start destroying plantations. But you're not allowed to kill monkeys. If you are in schedule 1, 2, 3, 4, if that animal is in schedule 1, 2, 3, 4, if you kill them, you'll go to jail or you'll be fined. You're not allowed to do that. But it becomes necessary sometimes. So in that situation, state government can request central government. State government can request central government to declare that particular species as vermin, whose killing would be allowed. And central government can allow, can declare that particular species in a particular area for a particular amount of time as vermin. For example, let's say Uttarakhand mein bandaron ne kohra macha rakha hai, or only in Haridwar they have created a lot of problems. So the Uttarakhand government will first request central government ki Modi ji please se vermin declare karwa dijiye. Then central government will say, okay, in Haridwar district, central government can choose the area in which it will be declared vermin. In Haridwar district, for next 10 months, monkey is vermin. Isse kya hoga? Killing of monkey would be allowed. This is given in section 62 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. तो वर्मिन भी डिक्लेयर किया जा सकता है. तो दिस ऑल्सो रिमेन्स इन न्यूज. यू सी दैट मंकीज वर डिक्लेयर्ड वर्मिन इन 11 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, 91 तहसील एंड सब तहसील ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश इन फेब्रुवरी 2019 फॉर वन ईयर. इट वॉज बिकॉज इंक्रीज पॉपुलेशन ऑफ मंकीज हैड स्टार्टेड इंपैक्टिंग फार्मर्स. द इंसिडेंस ऑफ क्रॉप्स बीइंग डैमेज्ड बाय मंकीज हैड बीन इंक्रीजिंग. So monkeys were declared vermin. So this declaration of vermin thing is also there in Wildlife Protection. So we have tried to cover various dimensions, various aspects of Wildlife Protection Act. I hope you understand it. This is for preliminary examination. When we will study this for mains examination, there we'll talk about why Wildlife Protection Act has, how Wildlife Protection Act has some problems, some limitations, and how can we reduce those limitations, how can we reduce those. Okay, I hope for preliminary examination, whatever was needed in Wildlife Protection Act, I have tried to cover those things here. Okay, now let's go to various protected areas which are there in the country. Kitne hai, kya hai, let's talk about that. Let's look at this table. Now, actually, the number of national park is 106 plus, because now number of these parks, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserve, community reserves keep on increasing. Abhi June mein hi do naye national parks banne hain. In Assam, two new national parks have been created, and soon we'll look at those things in the class. But currently, roughly these are the numbers. We have 100 plus national parks. We have 550 plus wildlife sanctuaries. We have 90 plus conservation reserve. We have 214 plus community reserve. Total, we have 980 plus protected areas. And these areas together contribute to around 5% of country's population. Here you will carefully see, even they haven't included tiger reserves. Because tiger reserves would already, the area of tiger reserve would already be included in the area of national park or wildlife sanctuaries. So double counting is not needed. That's why tiger reserve is a protected area. It is defined under Wildlife Protection Act. But still, here we have not included them. Here we have not included marine sanctuaries or marine national parks, because if they are national parks, they would be in the list of national park only. If they are wildlife sanctuaries, they would be in the list of wildlife sanctuaries only. So they are protected, but they would already be there. So alag se include karne ki zarurat nahi hai. So please note this, that India has 980 plus protected areas which cover 5% of India's territory. So if you are asked to, like in mains examination, if you are asked to write a question ki India ke protected area ke scenario ko critically analyze karo, let's analyze critically analyze the protected area regime of India. So your introduction could very well be, currently India has 980 plus protected areas covering 5% of India's total territorial area. This in itself is will tell the examiner, yes, you understand the scenario. You'll leave the first good impression. In preliminary examination, a statement may be there. Currently, India's protected area constitute around 20% of India's territorial area. You would say, no, this is definitely wrong. Forest cover is around 22%. Yes. But protected area, which is national park, wildlife sanctuary, conservation reserve, community reserve, is not, it's only 5% of the country's territory. I hope samajh mein aa rahi hai cheeze. Okay, now, states which have highest number of national parks, Madhya Pradesh has 9 national parks and Andaman and Nicobar Island has 9 national parks. Second highest now has become Assam. Assam now has 7 national parks. We'll talk about Assam today. Aaj hum North India ke national parks se deal karenge, we'll be discussing Assam. Then, if you look at wildlife sanctuaries, then it's Andaman and Nicobar Island which has highest number of wildlife sanctuaries. Before we get into national park and wildlife sanctuaries, there are two more small things that I want to discuss. One is world database on protected areas. World database on protected areas. Look, dekho, in examination hall, when you get a question and you feel like, yaar, iske baare mein to kuch bhi nahi pata, and you feel like, I do not know anything about this particular question, read it carefully. For example, you may be studying about world database on protected areas for the first time. But before getting into its detail, look at the name carefully. Database on protected areas. So what is it actually? It's a database of protected. We know India's protected areas kaun se hain. But ye world ka hai. World database on protected areas. In 2010, when it was updated, it had listed 1,61,000 protected areas. How many protected areas does India have? Around 1,000, 980 plus, around 1,000 protected areas India has. It had listed 1,61,000 protected areas all over the world. In territories and countries, like 236 countries and territories. You may be wondering, these are 236 countries to hai na? Yes, 236 countries and territories together. In 236 countries and territories, it had identified in October 2010, 1,61,000, it had listed 1,61,000 listings. Now, it's another factual thing you should know about this world database on protected area is that it's a joint venture between two bodies. One, UNEP, World Conservation Monitoring Center, and another, IUCN, World Commission on Protected Areas. Please, here, make one correction. यहाँ पे मैंने गलती से UNEP लिख दिया, it's IUCN. Like while writing the full form, I have written IUCN, but while typing the abbreviation, I have mentioned UNEP there. Please make it IUCN. Okay, now, so World Database on Protected Area is a joint initiative under UNEP World Conservation Monitoring Center and IUCN World Commission on Protected Areas. It lists protected areas all over the Fine. I hope ये world database on protected areas आपको समझ में आया. Now, national park and wildlife sanctuaries. What is the difference between national park and wildlife sanctuaries? For example, Obitora is a wildlife sanctuary. Whereas Kaziranga is a national park. Right. What are the key differences between national park and wildlife sanctuaries? Why do we have different kinds of protected areas in different kinds of protected areas in wildlife protection? So, by the way, in polity we have covered citizenship issue. So, in citizenship we had said no. There was earlier there used to be a person of Indian origin card holder. There was an OCI card holders. We had two different schemes for people of Indian origin. People who were not Indian citizens, but were of Indian origin and could get some benefits, they could get it under person of Indian origin card holder or OCI card holder. In the same way, when we are protecting different areas, different level of protection may be available for different areas. Eventually, 15 years, 20 years down the line, government may realize, "Arre yaar, let's convert everything into national park only. Let's provide all the benefits of OCI to PIOs also. So all the restrictions, all the protections which are available to national park, let's do it to wildlife sanctuaries also." But it's not right now. Right now, these two things are different. So what are the key differences? Now, wildlife sanctuaries are primarily focused on wildlife conservation. But national park is a wider goal. National park provides protection to entire ecosystem. It not only includes fauna, flora, but landscape, historical entities, sometimes even cultural entities are protected under national park. But wildlife sanctuary has limited goal, wildlife conservation. So its focus would be on population of wild animals, wild plants. Its focus is not as wide as national park. Then, when it comes to level of protection being provided, national park is given much higher protection. National parks have much higher level of restrictions in them. Like, you cannot enter a national park without taking permission. Wildlife sanctuaries, you'll be able to enter. In national park, you will not be allowed to live to do agricultural activities and all, generally. But wildlife sanctuaries, it may be. Of course, hunting is not allowed. Wildlife Protection Act does not allow hunting. So hunting is not allowed in any of the places. Mining industries, those would not be allowed in any of those places. But national parks has more levels of restriction. So here you will see, commercial exploitation of forest, not allowed anywhere, either in national park or in wildlife sanctuaries. Activities like hunting, grazing, human settlement, etc. are not allowed in national park. Whereas in wildlife sanctuary, hunting is not allowed. Hunting is prohibited. But grazing and movement of cattle may be permitted. To enter national park, you have to get permission. You have to get official permission. But no official permission may be required for entering a wildlife sanctuary. Then, boundaries of national park is very well defined. Why? If to enter national park you need permission, so kahan pe shuru ho raha hai, wo to pata hona chahiye na. Boundaries of wildlife sanctuaries are not that well specified. So IUCN has categorized various protected areas into category 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So basically, national park somehow relates to the category 2 of the IUCN protected area, whereas this corresponds to category 4 of IUCN protected. So I hope overall broad differences aapko samajh mein aa gaye. Now, management effective evaluation, MEE. What is this management effective evaluation? Thoda, we'll get to the notes, but before getting in there, let's broadly understand certain things. We have 980 protected areas. Now, how purpose of these protected areas is to protect wildlife, protect nature, protect environment, and thus promote sustainable development. But how effectively are these protected areas functioning? How effective is the protection? Uske liye koi measurement mechanism hona chahiye. This measurement mechanism has been provided by management effectiveness evaluation. So it is basically protected area management effectiveness evaluation. Protected areas management, how effective it is, its evaluation. So now you'll understand management effective evaluation ka matlab. It is protected area ka management ki effectiveness ka evaluation. So this management effective evaluation had been going on for some time. In the 2018-19 phase, another 140 plus protected area were evaluated. Its result was published in January 2021. Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change released NEE of 146 National Park and Wildlife Sanctuaries. Please note, we only have 100 something national park. So, here, national parks and wildlife sanctuaries together, 146 of them, uska result was published. This was for this phase. But jab se shuru hua hai, this management effective evaluation, tab se they have evaluated all the wildlife sanctuaries and national parks so far. In this phase, whose result was published in January 2021, the evaluation was for these 146 national park and wildlife sanctuaries. Now, here are certain things. What are the core things which are looked into when we are saying whether a protected area is functioning properly or not? One is the design issue. How that protected area and the various sites in that protected area have been designed. Second is adequacy and effectiveness of management system. And third is delivery of the objectives of national park and wildlife sanctuaries. That is the population of tiger increasing there? Is the population of other vulnerable animals or other threatened animals increasing, other threatened plants increasing? That is the adequacy and effectiveness. So in three dimensions, how have you designed the protected area and the conservation methods there? How adequate and effective this is, and overall, what is the how much of the objectives have been achieved? Now, this overall, now management effectiveness evaluation, what will it do? Agar aapko ek test ka result pata hai, so policy makers would be able to take right steps. If this NEE results show that this national park is very well, very badly managed, and therefore these species are more threatened. So if this kind of intervention is there, there are higher chances that you would be able to take steps, corrective steps to solve those issues, to take care of those issues. So between 2006 to 2019, all the national parks and wildlife sanctuaries have been evaluated so far. This year, 2019 ka result jo abhi aaya, 2021 mein, this year, the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change have also announced that from this year onward, that is from 2021 onwards, every year, 10 best national parks, 5 coastal and marine parks, and top 5 zoos in the country will be ranked and awarded every year. Best national parks, best zoos, best marine, 5 coastal and marine parks would be chosen and they would be awarded. Now, the result of the 2018-19 MEE. What is the result saying? The first 143 NPs were there. Overall MEE score is 62.01%, which they're considering to be very good because the global average is 56%. Which is the National Park Wildlife Sanctuary which did the best? You would see that Himalayan National Park and Great Himalayan National Park in Himachal Pradesh and Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary. So the Great Himalayan National Park is in the same way, Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary. Touch karke hi Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary. So this has scored the best. Its MEE score is 84.17%. So the best performing as per the latest evaluation, National Park or Wildlife Sanctuary is Great Himalayan National Park and Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary. Both of them have scored 84.17% each. Where is the worst performing? Sabse ganda, sabse kharab is the Turtle Wildlife Sanctuary, Kachua Wildlife Sanctuary in Varanasi. Its score was 26.6%. This is the only protected area which is focused on, which is dedicated to freshwater turtles in the country. But still, its score was so poor, its performance was so bad. Okay, Ritu has asked a question, sir. What is the difference between wildlife sanctuary and zoo? Beta, wildlife sanctuary mein jo hum protection de rahe hain, that is in the natural environment. Whereas zoo is a ex situ protection. Ex situ matlab jahan pe wo animal, like lions do not exist naturally in the zoo of Hyderabad. They have been kept in the cages. So zoo wo hota hai. Zoo is chidiyaghar. Wildlife sanctuaries, any forest area can be declared wildlife sanctuary and more protection can be provided. So it doesn't doubt hona nahi chahiye isme. Okay, I hope Ritu, you have got your doubt resolved. Now come back to this. So we are talking about which are the best performing ones and worst performing ones according to the latest data. In fact, if you look region wise, there are 143 total wildlife sanctuaries and national parks which were evaluated in the latest phase of evaluation under NEE. The worst performing region is northern region. Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu, Kashmir, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand. Himachal Pradesh jitna achha kar raha, Uttar Pradesh utna kharab kar raha. So overall result is the least score is that of this region. The best score is that of Eastern India, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha, West Bengal. Their score is 66.12. If you look at individual top five and bottom five national park wildlife sanctuaries, you will see the best score is that of Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary, Great Himalayan National Park, and Sains Wildlife Sanctuary. This Great Himalayan National Park ke aaspaas hi hain dono. Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary and Sains Wildlife Sanctuary, all three of them are in Himachal Pradesh. They have scored the best. See, in preliminary examination, in 2018, there was a question, a Pakhui Wildlife Sanctuary, kaun se state mein located? Pakhui was in news that year. It's in news this year also. Hum aaj bhi padhenge Pakhui ke baare mein. See, because it's a wildlife sanctuary, we'll study it tomorrow. But in the same way, Sains Wildlife Sanctuary, Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuaries, these are in news. These are the best performing wildlife sanctuaries. So if they ask you in the examination, Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary is located where? You should not say, sir, itne wild. There are 500 wildlife sanctuaries. Who will remember all of them? You do not have to remember all of them. Some important ones, like Pobitoro Wildlife Sanctuary, you should know where it is. And some in news. You should know this. National park will look at all national parks which are there. Okay, so the best performing ones are Tirthan, Great Himalayan and Sains Wildlife Sanctuary, Raiganj Wildlife Sanctuary and Jaldapada National Park in West Bengal are also among the top five performers. So Jaldapada National Park, we'll look at it today also. The worst performing ones, the worst of all is Turtle Wildlife Sanctuary in Uttar Pradesh. Very low score, 26.66. Then Khapadwas Wildlife Sanctuary in Haryana, 29.17. Ramasagar Wildlife Sanctuary, Rajasthan, 29.31. Pani Dhing Bird Wildlife Sanctuary, Assam. Then Jayaprakash Narayan Bird Wildlife Sanctuary, Uttar Pradesh. These are the worst wildlife sanctuaries, national parks in India as per the latest MEE. I hope samajh mein aa rahi hai cheez. Okay, now management effective evaluation so far had been going on for national parks and for wildlife sanctuaries. With the latest phase of evaluation, 2018-19 evaluation, we have covered all the national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. In 2021, in January 2021, the minister has announced that we are launching management effective evaluation initiative for zoos also. Zoos were not, Chidiyaghar were not covered so far. Now, how is the management of Chidiyaghar? What is the effectiveness of its management will also be covered. Its evaluation would also be done. For that, the various guidelines, criteria, indicators, etc. are being prepared, have been released. And this will not only look at traditional aspects, ki birds sare jinda bach rahe hain ya nahi, tiger ko khana mil raha hai nahi. It could look at other aspects also, like issues of animal welfare, husbandry, sustainability of resources, finances, all those things would be looked into, and zoos would be given this marks, these rankings, and accordingly performance would happen. Okay, so NEE for Indian zoos has also been announced from January 2020. Now, national parks. Now, what I've done is, while talking about national parks, I'm going state-wise, or state-wise, maybe I'm going from north to south and from east to west to east. So while going from north to south, मेरे को JNK या फिर लद्दाख से शुरू करना चाहिए था. I'm starting with Ladakh, then I'll go to JNK, Himachal, Uttarakhand, UP, Bihar, West Bengal, Sikkim, Assam, Arunachal, the northeast pura. And then tomorrow we will start with Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and so on. Okay, so let's start with the national parks in the northern India. The first national park that we want to start with is Hemis National Park. Now, whenever you hear the word Hemis, certain things should quickly come into your mind. It is the largest national park. So Hemis first, it's located in Ladakh. It is the largest national park. In fact, if you remove Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve, Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve is huge. If you remove Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve, then it's also the largest contiguous protected area in the country. First is this that you should know. Second thing that you should know about Hemis is, it is the only national park in India which is lying across Himalayas. So far, across Himalayas, we have not announced any, we have not declared any national park. Most of our national parks are located within Himalayas, before Himalayas. We have not crossed Himalayas and declared national park other than Hemis. Third and very important aspect is that it is considered the capital of snow leopards. Snow leopards are vulnerable. Himalayan regions mein milte hain. This is the place, Hemis is the place where highest population density of snow leopards is found. Snow leopard ke alawa yahan pe Tibetan wolf, Eurasian brown bear, red fox, all those Himalayan species are also found. Because it is lying across Himalayas, what happens across Himalayas? Rainfall is very less across Himalayas because the cloud, when the barrier of Himalayas come, they rise above and the rainfall occurs. So across the Himalayas, on the other side of Himalayas, rainfall would be very less. And therefore, because it's lying in rain shadow area, the forest which we have in Hemis is dry forest. It includes trees like juniper, populus, salix forest, subalpine, dry birch, etc. But these are dry forests. It also has, Hemis also has cultural significance. It houses various Tibetan gompas and holy kotens. This also includes the very famous Hemis Monastery. In UPSC, this question has been asked in the past, I guess. Hemis Monastery, kahan pe located hai? Buddhism se associated hai. This monastery is located in the Hemis National Park, the Ladakh region. See, it's important to know where Hemis is located. But more important, for perhaps PCS examination or SSC examination and all, just knowing where Hemis is located is enough. For UPSC, a number of other aspects of Hemis have to be understood. Last year, I think, Bala Singha, Chau Singha pe question aa gaya tha, iska answer Kanha National Park tha. Isi tarah se, they may ask you, one of the statements in one of the questions could be, which of the following is considered has the highest density of snow leopard? You should be able to answer that. They may give you a statement and say that this national park is the only national park which is lying across Himalayas in India, Hemis. This is the only national park of Ladakh. Since last 2 years, this is another thing that you should know. Pehle to Jammu and Kashmir mein tha, Ladakh bhi. Jammu and Kashmir has three other national parks. But now Ladakh is a separate union territory. Jammu and Kashmir is a separate union territory. This is the only national park in Ladakh. Are you able to understand this? The whole thing? Okay. So, Hemis ke baare mein basic cheezein aapko pata hai. Now, let's go to Jammu and Kashmir ke national park. So, Jammu and Kashmir have three important national parks. Dachigam, Salim Ali National Park, also known as the City Forest National Park, and Kishtawar National Park. Isme se Dachigam is very important. You should know about it very well. It's because of the Hangul's population. We know about Hangul. We have studied about Hangul in biodiversity in the when we are dealing with the species. This is Dachigam National Park near Srinagar is the only place where viable population of Hangul is present. In no other place in the country, a viable population is present. So Dachigam National Park is located near Srinagar, there is Salim Ali National Park. Now, by the way, Dachigam National Park mein aur snow leopard, red fox, musk deer, black deer, brown deer, yellow-throated marten, Himalayan weasel, ye sab bhi mil rahe hai, you do not have to remember them. Again, snow leopard pure Himalayan belt mein milta hai. So, yahan pe bhi milna chahiye. Other things you'll do by common sense, the most important animal you should know about, the Hemis ke liye snow leopard hai, yahan ke liye hangul. But you do not have to remember, read them once and understand by common sense, will I assume the same thing? Yes, you would assume the same thing, that's fine. Okay, now, Salim Ali. You must be knowing that Salim Ali is known as the Birdman of India. He is someone who has studied a lot about birds of India. So, in his name, there are other wildlife sanctuaries also. This is a national park, Salim Ali National Park, which is located in the city of Srinagar. Now, please note that it is located within the city of Srinagar. So, it cannot be of 1,000 square kilometers. City of Srinagar itself would be very small. So it is a very small national park. A national park whose area is only 9 kilometers square. 9 kilometer into 1 kilometer, I say roughly assume karo area. So you have to 22 kilometer ka half marathon run. Karna hai. You can run around Salim Ali. It's this small. Then, yahan pe bhi Hangul, musk deer, Himalayan black deer, leopard, Himalayan Sheru, etc. Milenge. Then Kishtawar is also there. Kishtawar is also located in Jammu and Kashmir. Snow leopard, markhor, musk deer, brown deer. So basically Himalayan animals are found. So far, you have looked at Hemis in Ladakh, Dachigam, Salim Ali, and Kishtawar in Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir is ek aur national park, hai, but wo announced hai, abhi tak ispe kuch hua nahi hai, so we are not studying it. So four national parks we have studied so far. Ek bar sabke go through, like in your head, go through these four national parks once. So that bhuloge nahi kabhi. Hemis, significance, importance of Hemis. Dachigam, significance, importance. Salim Ali, significance, importance. Small area and all that thing. And Kishtawar. The four national parks done so far. Now we will go to Himachal Pradesh. Great Himalayan National Park. GHNP. It's located in the Kullu region of the Himachal Pradesh. Now, this Great Himalayan National Park is also UNESCO's World Heritage Site. One of the UNESCO's World Heritage Site. In fact, this status was granted in 2014. Now, agar aap important fauna dekhoge is national park ka, so again, snow leopard, blue sheep, Himalayan brown bear, Himalayan tar, musk deer, those Himalayan species are there. Then there is one more national, there are a few more national parks in Himachal Pradesh, Indar Kila, Khir Ganga, Pin Valley, Karnal Sherzung, Simbal Bara. I'm not getting into their details, just read them once. Khir Ganga. Generally, people would be confused. Ki, acha, ye Himachal mein rahega, ki Uttarakhand mein rahega. You have studied it once, so you would know that it's in Uttarakhand. Not very important. Bahut zyada news mein nahi the, but I want to make you go through all the 100 plus national parks. So I have listed the remaining national parks here. Okay, Great Himalayan National Park is actually a big, huge national park. You'll see its area is 1171 square kilometers. Think of Kalibali National Park, 9 kilometers square. 9 kilometers square and 1171 kilometers square. This is like 100 times more the size of the Salim Ali National Park of Jammu and Kashmir. Then we have Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand mein at top we have Gangotri National Park, which is located in Uttarkashi district. Gangotri National Park is also one of the largest national parks of the country. In fact, it is the fourth largest national park in the country. Highest, largest is Himis. Second largest would be Desert National Park of Rajasthan. Third would be Simlipal. Desert, Rajasthan, Simlipal, Odisha. Both of these we would be studying tomorrow. So, Himis, Desert, Simlipal, and then fourth pe hai Gangotri National Park. Now, Gangotri region, high region, hilly region, coniferous trees would be the aspect here. Look at its location on the map. Gangotri National Park borders China. Ye ek important aspect hai. So, Gangotri National Park is along the international border with China. Now, animals, fauna, snow leopard and all would be found here. Then we have Valley of Flower National Park. Maybe some of you may have gone for a trek to Valley of Flower in Uttarakhand. Like for those of you who are from IIT Roorkee, Roorkee wale saath bachche first year mein jaate hain. Zyadatar bachche first year mein Valley of Flower ja rahe hote hain. So this Valley of Flower Uttarakhand mein hai, Chamoli mein located hai. Now it is known for its meadows of endemic alpine flowers. So sometimes a statement like this is given. This national park is known for its meadows of endemic alpine flowers, and you feel like it is complicated. Kuch aa gaya. Valley of Flower. People visit it for these meadows. Okay, now species: musk deer, snow leopard, brown bear, blue sheep. Again, all common ones of Himalayas would be found here also. So in Uttarakhand, we have looked at Gangotri, we have looked at Valley of Flower National Park. गंगोत्री के बारे में एक सिग्निफिकेंट चीज पढ़ी थी, बॉर्डर कर रहा है चाइना को. वैली ऑफ फ्लावर, द नेम इटसेल्फ इज टॉकिंग अबाउट मेडोज. गंगोत्री नॉर्दर्न मोस्ट है उत्तराखंड में, नॉर्दर्न मोस्ट. लुक एट मैप, इन मैप वेयर इज गंगोत्री, यहां उत्तराखंड का बॉर्डर, यहां एंड वेयर इज वैली ऑफ फ्लावर. गंगोत्री वॉज हेयर, वैली ऑफ फ्लावर इज हेयर. Gangotri is the northernmost, then comes Valley of Flower. Then we have, by the way, in this class, within a state, I have not differentiated between north to south and east to west. Theek hai? Within a state, I have not done this discrimination. State, I have gone through, like I'm covering state, northernmost state first, then or niche, and from west to east in general. Within a state, I have not done it. This was just a coincidence ki Gangotri pehle upar aa gaya and then came Valley of Flower. Now, come to the most important national park of Uttarakhand, Nanda Devi. Nanda Devi is also a biosphere reserve. Hello, I'll take a small break. Koi mujhe batao, all the 12 biosphere reserves of India. Raise your hand. और साउथ से बताना शुरू करो. ऑल द 12 बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व ऑफ इंडिया विच आर इन मैन एंड बायोस्फीयर प्रोग्राम. देखो, नो वन हैज रेज्ड हैंड. 3 बजे सुबह उठ के कोई पूछे और बताने की पॉसिबिलिटी होनी चाहिए, वो होना चाहिए ना. क्षितिज तिवारी हैज रेज्ड हैंड. क्षितिज जी बताइए, फ्रॉम साउथ टू नॉर्थ बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व ऑफ इंडिया.
यस सर. सर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल निकोबार आइलैंड,
ग्रेट निकोबार बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व,
देन गल्फ ऑफ मन्नार बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व,
गल्फ ऑफ मन्नार,
देन अगस्त्यमलाई
नीलगिरी,
Then Simlipal.
Simlipal.
Then Achanakmar Biosphere Reserve.
Okay, 6.
Panchmadhi.
Panchmadhi, 7.
Panna.
Panna, 8.
Then Sundarbans.
Sundarban, 9.
Then Nokrek.
Nokrek, 10. And
then Kanchanjunga.
Kanchanjunga, 11.
And then 12th is Nanda Devi.
Nanda Devi, 12.
Yeah.
Achha, 6, which are not, someone else. Please lower your hands. I want to, 6 of the biosphere reserves in India, which are not part of Nayanan Biosphere Program. Again, we'll go from north to south, state-wise. Kaun batae? Is there any raised hand? Chitish ka hai, nahi Chitish ke alawa. Ye online mein pata nahi lag raha, aap logon ne booklet khol rakhi hai ki nahi khol rakhi. जिसने अपना वीडियो ऑन कर रखा है सिर्फ वो बताएं. नहीं, देयर इज नो वन. दिस इज नॉट फेयर. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. शेषाचलम है आंध्र प्रदेश में, राइट? ऊपर जाओगे मानस है, दिहांग दिबांग है ना. इधर आओगे रन ऑफ कच्छ है. सिंपल है. लाइक हमेशा अपने टिप्स पे रखो. जब आप लाइव पढ़ रहे हो ना, तो वो क्लास वाली फीलिंग आनी चाहिए. सर कुछ भी पूछेंगे, वी शुड बी रेडी, वी शुड हैव रिवाइज्ड एवरीथिंग. ओके, तो टुमारो लेट्स डू दिस. आई विल डेफिनेटली टेक अ क्लास टुमारो. जस्ट अगर क्लासरूम अवेलेबल होगा. आई नेवर रियलाइज दैट इवन आफ्टर हैविंग टू क्लासरूम्स, लेवल अप मुझे ही टाइम नहीं दे पाएगा सुबह से शाम में. कोई इतने सारे कोर्सेस हम स्टार्ट कर देंगे 6-7 महीने में ही. तो इफ आई एम एबल टू गेट अ क्लासरूम, आई विल डेफिनेटली टेक अ क्लास टुमारो. बट एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ क्लास टुमारो आई एम गोना आस्क यू, कौन से नेशनल पार्क कौन से स्टेट में है, कौन से बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व कौन से स्टेट में है, क्या सिग्निफिकेंस है, बिफोर आई जंप ऑन टू द अदर वंस. एंड कल थोड़ा नहा धो लेना आप लोग, सो दैट यू कैन कम इन फ्रंट ऑफ द वीडियो. स्विच ऑन योर वीडियोस. जो लोग मतलब वीडियो नहीं ऑन करे हुए हैं, आई एम अज्यूमिंग कि वो नहाते धोते नहीं है, बस पड़े हुए हैं. एंड तो नंदा देवी नेशनल पार्क और बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. नाउ दिस नेशनल पार्क, नंदा देवी का इमेज नीचे कैसे चला गया. दिस नेशनल पार्क, नंदा देवी नेशनल पार्क इज ऑल्सो सिचुएटेड अराउंड द पीक ऑफ नंदा देवी. तो नंदा देवी पीक इज इन उत्तराखंड, 7,800 meters से ऊपर है. इट्स अ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. इट वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड अ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज इन 1988. इट वॉज नाउ द नंदा देवी बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. नंदा देवी नेशनल पार्क इज नंदा देवी नेशनल पार्क, बट नंदा देवी बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व इज नॉट नंदा देवी बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. इट्स नंदा देवी एंड वैली ऑफ फ्लावर बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. जो बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व का नाम है ना, दैट इज नंदा देवी एंड वैली ऑफ फ्लावर. वैली ऑफ फ्लावर was added into that list. Valley of Flower and Nanda Devi are encompassed in the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve now. So both parts are there. Valley of Flower and this together forms the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. Now come to Rajaji National Park. Rajaji National Park. Rajaji National Park. It's also located in Uttarakhand. It has been named after C. Rajagopalachari, an eminent freedom fighter from India, also the last Governor General of India. Iske baad we had our president, hum republic ban gaye. So C. Rajagopalachari was also the last Governor General of India. Unke naam pe Rajaji National Park hai. It is also a tiger reserve. Corbett was the first tiger reserve. It was the second tiger reserve. Now, where is it located? Aap dekhenge, it's located very near to Uttar Pradesh. Aap Uttar Pradesh, when you go to Uttarakhand, jaise when we went to Roorkee, so those were, Haridwar was among the first district. It is very near here. You can see Haridwar, Dehradun, Pauri, Gadwal. These are the areas which are covered by this. It became second tiger reserve of Uttarakhand very recently in 2015. The first one was Corbett, and rivers like Ganga and Song flows through it. These basic things about Sri Rajagopal Tarini Rajaji National Park. Then Jim Corbett. It was in news abhi in June 2021 also. Jim Corbett National Park was in news because the government of Uttarakhand have announced that Jim Corbett will be kept open throughout the year. So far, generally, national parks were closed during monsoon period. Now, monsoon is starting, but government has announced that it will be kept open. We'll talk about why it was closed and why it has been kept open. But for now, but before that, let us start with fundamentals, basic things about Jim Corbett that you should know. Jim Corbett, located in Uttarakhand, that's fine. But it's also the first national park of India. Sabse pehle, it was this national park. In 1936, it was established as Haley National Park in the Nainital district of Uttarakhand. Later, Jim Corbett unka naam rakh diya gaya tha. Now, it is also the first tiger reserve in India. When the Project Tiger was started, under that tiger reserves were created. It was Jim Corbett which was the first tiger reserve in India. It is also the tiger reserve with highest number of tigers. A correction humne diya tha class, fifth class mein, in the fourth booklet we had done it. Now, and it's also among very few tiger reserves in the country which allows overnight stay within the national park. Tourists can stay overnight, and kyunki raat mein tigers ke dikhne ke chances badh jayenge, to enjoy the beauty of the national park. Okay, some basic things. Sabse purana hai. Purana National Park, oldest national park, oldest tiger reserve also. The tiger reserve with highest number of tigers. Located in Haridwar, Dehradun, Pauri districts. These basic things about the park you should know. Now, why the decision of keeping the park open throughout the year has been taken? Before that, why are parks generally closed during monsoon? First, we should understand this. So, generally, people would, one speculation would be ki tigers ka breeding period hoga, so tiger reserves are generally closed during monsoon. So that's not true. Tigers do it throughout the year. Unke liye koi breeding season specific nahi. Okay, generally national parks are closed during monsoon, during rainy season, because for humans it's difficult. Like if Raja Maharaja hua karte thi. So during monsoon they did not go for hunting because paths were destroyed. Sometimes, like even now, roads are destroyed. Jo gali, jo kacche road hote hain, wahan pe by flow of water, a lot of changes may take place. That is one factor. It is difficult for humans to enter national park at that time, because of which generally it is not allowed. But there are other aspects also. Though tigers do not specifically breed during monsoon, a number of other species prefer Sawan ka mahina to breed or to mate and get ready for breeding. Their existence is also important if you want to protect tigers. That's another reason why it is closed. Then, jo Raja Maharaja hote the kings and all, they did not go for hunting during monsoon. But poachers, they prefer monsoon. Poachers prefer monsoon. Why do they prefer monsoon? They prefer monsoon because in the interiors, it would be difficult for police, forest service officer, forest service people to catch them. So the national park is also closed so that focus can be more on poachers. The guards and all can focus more on them rather than on tourists. So for all these reasons, so far, the national park, the Corbett National Park, generally was closed for 4 or 5 months. Some part was closed for 4 months, some part was closed for 5 months, but it was closed. But now it has been decided that it would remain open, mostly for tourism purposes. But how effective it would be, like what kind of infrastructure will have to be created in the jungles in the forests? Should we create that kind of like permanent roads and all in the jungles? All those issues are there, and therefore generally environmentalists are criticizing this move. But abhi recently, June mein, this debate is going on in Corbett National Park. Okay, now, Govind Pashu Vihar National Park. You must be knowing about Govind Vallabh Pant, another eminent freedom fighter of India. Unke naam pe ye national park rakha gaya hai. It is located in Uttarakhand in the Gadwal Himalayas, and a project, Snow Leopard. Snow Leopard project was started by government here in this national park. So Govind Vallabh Pant ke naam pe to hai Govind Pashu Vihar National Park. So 6 national parks of Uttarakhand. Soch sakte ho, ek bar, we started with Gangotri. सबसे ऊपर गंगोत्री हमने देखा, राइट? गंगोत्री के नीचे क्या देखा था हमने? कोई बताओ मुझे, 6 के 6 नेशनल पार्क. एनीवन, जस्ट अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड स्टार्ट स्पीकिंग. यस यस, मैं आपका नाम भूल गया, त्यागी जी. कुशाग्र, हाँ बताओ.
सो वैली ऑफ फ्लावर, गंगोत्री फर्स्ट, देन वैली ऑफ फ्लावर्स, देन नंदा देवी, then Rajaji, Jim Corbett. Rajaji, Jim Corbett. Then it's
Vallabh Pant,
Govind Pashuvihar. Yes.
Now the 2 freedom fighters are there in Uttarakhand list of national park. Okay. 2 freedom fighters are there. 2. I think any. वो उत्तराखंड खत्म हो गया था. हरियाणा से शुरू करेंगे. रिकॉर्डिंग हो रही है, कर दूं शुरू?
यस.
अभी तो बंद है ना? Okay, now let's move on to national parks of Haryana. In Haryana, the first national park that we want to talk about is the Sultanpur National Park. Sultanpur National Park, abhi recently news mein tha because of avian influenza, bahut sare dead birds wahan mile the. It is located very near to us, very near to Delhi. I think it's located near Gurgaon. It's in Sultanpur village of the Gurgaon district. And it's known for water birds and migratory birds. And therefore, the avian influenza hua tha, a lot of birds had died there. It was in news. Further, it was in news in 2020, December 2020 also, when around 130 bird species had arrived to this national park. Now, of this 130 bird species, there was a decline. When compared to previous year, there was a decline. And thus, it was there in news. There is another national park in Haryana, Kalesar National Park, which is located in Yamunanagar district. Jada important nahi, just know that Kalesar National Park is located in Yamunanagar. So, Haryana mein, we have 2 national parks, the Sultanpur and the Kalesar in Yamunanagar district. Now, let's come to Uttar Pradesh, the national parks in Uttar Pradesh. The first one that we want to discuss is the Dudhwa National Park. Dudhwa National Park is located. Yahan pe actually something has gone wrong. In your notes, things would be okay, I guess. In your notes, you would be able to see that Uttar Pradesh ke top mein wahan pe Dudhwa National Park is located. So Lakhimpur Bharej district mein it's located. In fact, when you look at Dudhwa Tiger Reserve, it not only covers Dudhwa National Park but also covers Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary and Katrani Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary. So Kishanpur, Katrani Ghat, 2 wildlife sanctuaries, and Dudhwa National Park together forms Dudhwa Tiger Reserve. So overall, its total area is 1,000 km² and It is an important national park in tiger reserve in Uttar Pradesh. If you go to Bihar, Bihar has only one national park. This is also a tiger reserve and wildlife sanctuary, Valmiki National Park. West Champaran. Champaran East and Champaran West. West mein jo jayenge, that will be West Champaran. In West Champaran district, we have Valmiki National Park. This Valmiki National Park borders Nepal's Chitwan National Park. Kyunki border pe hai jungle, to aise jungle border ke saath khatam nahi ho jayega. Forest would be extended to other part. So on the other side, we have Chitwan National Park. This national park is located on the bank of Gandak. And Bihar mein sirf ek hi national park hai. Dekho, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, these have very less forest areas because of very high population density, and Ganga plain makes the region very fertile. People go for deforestation, destroy forests to get more fertile land for agriculture. Therefore, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar do not have a lot of national parks. Then we have Betla National Park, Tiger Reserve in Jharkhand. Jharkhand also has only this national park. And its figure is here. Betla National Park is located in Jharkhand. In my notes, it has just been modified a bit. Now, let's come to West Bengal. West Bengal has lots of them. Sabse pehle, the most important one, Sundarban National Park, Tiger Reserve, Biosphere Reserve, also a Ramsar site. That will tell you the significance, importance of Sundarban. Now, Sundarban is known for Sundari trees or the mangrove forest. We've already seen that Sundarbans has the largest area under mangroves in the country. Okay, now it's also one of the largest reserves for Bengal tiger. Yahan pe aur bhi saltwater crocodile, fishing cats, leopards, etc. are found. Threatened species mein royal Bengal tiger, saltwater crocodile, river terrapin, olive ridley sea turtle, Ganges river dolphin, hawksbill sea turtle, all those things can be found here. Then we have Gorumara National Park. Look at it, northern Bengal mein. Here we have Gorumara National Park in Jalpaiguri district. This national park is pretty small, 80 square kilometers, and is located in the Duar region of West Bengal. Through this national park, this national park is located in the floodplains of Murti and Raidak River. This place is very important for Indian rhino. It is mostly because of Indian rhino that it was declared a national park. Then, conservation focus mein bhi aap dekhenge, maintain a viable breeding community of Indian rhino. Then we have Jaldapada National Park. This is, Jaldapada is also located on the northern Bengal region, and in sabke images thode gadbad ho gaye. Jaldapada is also located in northern Bengal region. Say Kalimpong is also located in northern Bengal region. Jaldapada is important because it has the second largest rhino population. After Kaziranga, highest number of rhinos are found in Jaldapada National Park. Neora Valley National Park is again there. Then we have Singula National Park. It's also in the northern Bengal in the Darjeeling region. And finally, Baksa National Park as well as Tiger Reserve. We know that this was one of the national parks where we did not find any tiger. This while finding tiger, we had talked about Baksa. Baksa is also located in the Darjeeling Valley region. You will see it's located in the northern part of Bengal. These 5-6 national parks are there of West Bengal. Sare important nahi hai. Sundarban is very important. Baksa is very, very important. And then this one, Jaldapada, which has the second largest rhino population, is very, very important. Then, Kanchenjunga National Park or Kanchenjunga Biosphere Reserve in Sikkim. It's a biosphere reserve that we already know. I think Kushagra had just talked about this. Now, the National Park Biosphere Reserve is a much larger area. And we have seen that Biosphere Reserve has core area, Biosphere Reserve has बफर एरिया ट्रांजिशन एरिया वो तरह से डिविजन है. द नेशनल पार्क फॉर्म्स द कोर एरिया ऑफ दिस बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. द कंचनजंगा नेशनल पार्क फॉर्म्स द कोर एरिया ऑफ द कंचनजंगा बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. This biosphere reserve or this national park also include the third highest peak, Mount Kanchenjunga. This is the third highest peak in the world. It's located in there. Then it is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It was listed in July 2016. Then it was a mixed World Heritage Site as far as I remember. Natural bhi tha aur cultural bhi tha. Then it was added in UNESCO's Man and Biosphere Program also. I think this also happened in 2017-18. Cultural significance देखोगे तो Lepcha tribal settlements are located within the park. There are monasteries like Tholung Monastery which are located here. Then right across the border we have Komalanga National Nature Preserve in Tibet and Kanchenjunga Conservation Area in Nepal. So Kanchenjunga National Park Biosphere Reserve borders on northern side to China. To Komalanga National Natural Reserve and on the eastern side with Kanchenjunga Conservation Area. Okay, now comes Assam. Assam for this year's exam is the most important state in terms of protected areas because two new protected area add ho gaye till last year. Two new national park add ho gaye till last year. It used to have 5 national park. Today it has 7 national parks, second highest in the country. Highest 9 in Madhya Pradesh and in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now, first, I'm looking at the locations of these national parks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This one, the westernmost, the Hingpalakri. And the easternmost ka naam ek second dijiye mujhe. Easternmost is called Raimona, have been added recently. This westernmost and easternmost, this you must be knowing is Kaziranga. This is Kaziranga on the southern bank of Brahmaputra. This is Manas National Park, Royal Mora, Manas Bhutan ko touch karta hai kyunki Bhutan mein Royal Manas shuru hota hai. Theek hai. Here we have Nameri is touching Arunachal Pradesh. And on the Arunachal Pradesh side, Nameri has what? Nameri has Pathui Wildlife Sanctuary. So Nameri National Park on the Arunachal Pradesh is Pathui Wildlife Sanctuary. This is Orang National Park. Orang is located on the northern bank of Brahmaputra. This is Kaziranga, this is Orang, this is Nameri, this is Manas, this is the abhi jo naya bana hai main iska naam bhul jata hu baar baar, Raimona National Park. Then this is Dihang Debang and this is Dehingpatkai. Okay, so let's talk about all these one by one. We'll start with the first one, located very near Bhutan border on this side and West Bengal on this side. It is Raimona National Park. On 5th of June 2021, it was announced by Assam government, and on 9th of June, by notifying the Assam Gazette notification, a new national park, Raimona National Park, was created in Assam. It's located in the northwestern part of Assam, in the Kokrajhar district, jahan borderland territorial region jo hai, it is located there. So the area here includes Ripu Reserve Forest. The northern part of the notified area is Ripu Reserve Forest. And this Ripu Reserve Forest is also the westernmost buffer of the Manas National Park. If you'll go to this figure again, यहां पे कहीं पे मानस है, सॉरी यहां पे कहीं पे मानस है, राइट. तो मानस के बाहर देयर इज बफर जोन ऑफ मानस, दैट इज दिस फॉरेस्ट, रिपू रिजर्व फॉरेस्ट. एंड उसके जस्ट बगल में वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद रायमोना नेशनल पार्क. नाउ रायमोना नेशनल पार्क इज बाउंड बाय मेनी रिवर्स. यू सी लेट्स से दिस इज माय रायमोना नेशनल पार्क. व्हाट हैपेंड? Let's say this is my Raimona National Park. Let's say this is Raimona National Park. So on the west, on this side of Raimona, Assam ke bagal mein kya hai? West Bengal. On this side of Raimona, we have a river called Sankosh River, which is bordering, creating a border between Assam and West Bengal. It runs southwards, starting from India, Bhutan, Sankosh River. Santosh, nahi Sankosh. Second, we have Saral Bhanga River. It forms the eastern boundary. Then we have Tekua River. Tekua River forms the southern boundary. And on the northern side, we have these national park, contiguous forest patches of Phipso Wildlife Sanctuary and Zigme Singya Wangchung National Park of Bhutan. On the northern side, Bhutan aa jata hai, so we have Singye Wangchuk National Park in Bhutan. So, in a way, what is happening? This national park, the new national park that we created, has become part of the contiguous forest patch. On the Bhutan side, the forest patch was already a national park. On this side, it has now become a national park. So protection, transboundary would become, it would become transboundary. Now, then we have Manas National Park. So Manas ke bare mein, while studying pygmy hog, we had said that pygmy hog population Manas ke tarai grasslands mein hi mil raha hai. For pygmy hog population, there's a project called Pygmy Hog Conservation Program, PHCP. Let us first study about Pygmy Hog Conservation Program and the news before we get into the details of Manas. This Pygmy Hog Conservation Program is running in collaboration with Dural Wildlife Conservation Trust. Dural was a conservationist. Unke naam pe trust bana hai UK mein. Assam Forest Department, Wild Pig Specialist Group of International Union for Conservation of Nature and Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. They have come together to establish this Pygmy Hog Conservation Program. Under this program, what was done? First, six of the hogs, four females and two males, were captured from the wild. Then, unka captive breeding karwaya gaya. And after that, pygmy hog, captively bred pygmy hog, are being released in nature again. For example, 2008 mein it started, pehle Sonai Rupai Wildlife Sanctuary, Orang National Park, Barandi Wildlife Sanctuary, and so on. It was introduced. It was this introduction in Manas National Park in June 2021 that was in news. In June 2021, 146 pygmy hogs have been introduced in wild because of this pygmy hog conservation project. And therefore, and we do not even have these many numbers of wild pygmy hogs. Jitne hamare paas jungle mein pygmy hogs the, usse jyada, the number of pygmy hogs that we had in wild, more than that number of pygmy hogs we have introduced because of this program, indicating how successful this program is. Pygmy Hog Conservation Project. It was in news recently because Pygmy Hog Conservation Project ki wajah se a few more, 12 more pygmy hogs were reintroduced in Manas National Park in June 2021. The news was that. So I also wanted to cover this Pygmy Hog Conservation Project. Now, about Manas National Park, there are some things that you should know that it was declared a sanctuary in 1928. It became a World Heritage Site in 1985. Then it also had become a World Heritage Site in danger in 1992. That status was removed in 2010 when its situation improved. So it is known for rhino population. It is known for wild buffalo population. It's also known for right across the border. We have Royal Manas National Park. You remember that? Royal Manas ke bare mein humne baat kari hai. On the Bhutan side, we have the Royal Manas thing. So it was there. So Manas National Park, please note carefully, Manas is not on the bank of Brahmaputra. Kaziranga was, hum confused. Manas is a very famous national park of Assam. We may get confused and we may feel like Hoga Chad. It's far away. It's on the Bhutan border. That's why Royal Manas on the Bhutan side. Right? Carefully note this. The first one, Raimona National Park, it's also not on the borders of Brahmaputra. Tributary way, not Brahmaputra directly. Second one is also not on the banks of Brahmaputra. Now comes the third one, Kaziranga National Park.
The most important, the most famous
for one horned rhino. It's located, it's a World Heritage Site, it's a tiger reserve, it's an important bird area, and the 2/3 of the rhino population of the world, 2/3 of the one horned rhino are found here. Kaziranga also has one of the highest tiger densities.
Up most dense tiger reserves mein bhi jaoge
to isme hai tiger bandar zyada nahi hai, but because of size is less, its density is very high. Elephants, water buffalo, swamp deer are some other animals which are found here. Now where is it located? Look at this, Brahmaputra River, on the southern bank of Brahmaputra River. This image will give you more clarity. This is Brahmaputra River. On the southern bank of Brahmaputra River, we have Kaziranga National Park. Kaziranga is on the southern bank here. Within Kaziranga, like Kaziranga itself is crisscrossed by three rivers, but it's located on the southern bank. Now, stone mining has become a concern for Kaziranga. Now you would say, sir, national park mein to mining allowed hi nahi hota. Yes, it's not allowed in national park. Stone mining is allowed in this region. It's outside national park. Right. But what happens is, during flooding season, on those hills which are outside national park, lots of animals migrate. So because of mining activities, what's happening? Because of mining activities, this migration is becoming hampered, is getting hampered. A number of river streams from those hills flow into the Kaziranga. Because of the mining activities there, that flow has been hindered. The water which is coming is more turbid, is more polluted. The flood situation has deteriorated. All those problems are occurring. And therefore, उसका भी क्रिटिसिज्म हो रहा है. तो काजीरंगा में माइनिंग नहीं है, बट काजीरंगा के बियॉन्ड जो हिली टेरेन है, कार्बी एंगलोंग रीजन है, वहां पे क्वेरिंग हो रही है, उसकी वजह से प्रॉब्लम्स हैं. दैट वाज आल्सो न्यूज. देन स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ काजीरंगा इन टू डिविजन. दिस इज अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट इवेंट दैट हैज हैपेंड. सी, बिफोर दिस काजीरंगा वॉज अ सिंगल डिविजन. तो वेन यू आर अ सिंगल डिविजन, तो सिंगल सेट ऑफ ऑफिसर्स आर देयर. सो इन दैट सिचुएशन, most of the officers were available. So there are actually earlier, most of the officers focused on the southern part of Kaziranga. Now by splitting Kaziranga into Eastern Assam and Vishwanath division, we'll be creating two separate divisions, so two separate set of officers who would ensure two divisional forest officials who will ensure better protection of Kaziranga throughout. So a part of Kaziranga is from the northern side of Brahmaputra, and much of the poaching was done from northern side of Brahmaputra, and that's why by creating these two divisions, focus on that part would also improve. Then we have Orang National Park. Orang National Park is on the northern bank of Brahmaputra. Kaziranga was on southern bank of Brahmaputra. Kaziranga kahin yahan pe tha. Orang is here. It is on the northern bank of Brahmaputra. It is also known for one-horned rhino, pygmy hog, elephants. In fact, if you remember Bengal Florican, one of the critically endangered birds, wo Bengal mein nahi mil raha tha, UP mein mil raha tha, Assam mein mil raha tha, Arunachal Pradesh mein mil raha tha, is found here. Around 30-40 population of this thing is found here. Then Nameri National Park. Nameri National Park is on Arunachal border. It is associated with this Namiri National Park, connected to this Namiri National Park is Pakhui Wildlife Sanctuary or Pakhui Tiger Reserve, also known as Pakhe Tiger Reserve, which was asked in prelims 2018. Namiri National Park of Assam, Pakhui National Park, oh sorry, Pakhui Tiger Reserve, Pakhui Wildlife Sanctuary of Arunachal Pradesh. So, ye border pe hai, that is important. Then we have Dibru Saikova. I'm sorry, maine se galti se Dihang Debang bola tha. Dihang Debang is located in Arunachal Pradesh. We have Dibru Saikova National Park. Dibru Saikova National Park is also located on the banks of Brahmaputra. It is located in Tinsukia, Dibrugarh district. It is bounded by Brahmaputra and Lohit rivers, and some bird species and all those are there. And then a new national park, Dihing Patkai National Park. Dihing Patkai was announced in December 2020 only, but its official notification happened in June 2021 and it has become the 7th national park. Now, carefully note, Dihing Patkai is located here. Dihing Patkai is located here, far away from Brahmaputra. So, Orang on the northern side of Brahmaputra, Kaziranga on the southern side of Brahmaputra, the Dibru Saikova National Park or Biosphere Reserve on Brahmaputra, on the banks of Brahmaputra, but Dihing Patkai is further away. Now, this Dihing National Park is contiguous stretch of forest, which was earlier called Upper Dihing Forest in the east, and the Jaipur Reserve Forest under Dibrugarh Division. So, those set of forests hai, which are part of this. These forests are very pristine, has not been interfered a lot, and are located on Assam-Arunachal border, on this part of Arunachal, not the northern part of Arunachal. Assam also border Arunachal on the eastern side. So, on this side of Arunachal, ye ho raha hai. This region, the Dihing Patkai region, is called Amazon of Northeast India or of the East. Because Amazon mein kya milte hai? Tropical wet forest, those tropical forests are also found here. In fact, the Dihing Patkai forms the largest stretch of lowland forest in India. And because they are completely virgin forest, not interfered by humans, they are very rich in biodiversity, very significant, and a number of important species. For example, Chinese pangolin, which is critically endangered, flying fox, wild pig, sambar, barking deer, all are found here. This is the only species of sanctuary, now a national park. Earlier it was only a wildlife sanctuary, now a national park, where we have 7 species of wild cats. We have tiger here, we have leopard here, we have clouded leopard here, we have leopard cat, golden cat, and marble cat. And this Dihing Patkai National Park is a sub part of Dihing Patkai Elephant Reserve. Elephant Reserve is much larger. Aspas ke region ko bhi Elephant Reserves mein dala gaya hai. Dihing Patkai National Park is a sub part of the big Dihing Patkai Elephant Reserve. Okay, now Arunachal Pradesh. The Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh is Nam Dafa Tiger Reserve, or National Park is Nam Dafa National Park. I think we already covered it while dealing with Nam Dafa Flying Squirrel. Why the flying squirrel was called Nam Dafa? Why the flying squirrel was called flying? It was not actually flying. It used to glide. When it jumped from one tree to another, one branch to another, it glided. And that's why it was called flying squirrel. It has been named after this place, Nam Dafa. Now, Nam Dafa endemic hai, dhol, red panda wagera milte hain. Ek important cheez thi iske bare mein. Ha, important yahan pe. A Moling National Park. Moling National Park is very important because to Dihang Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary hai. It is part of that. Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve. We have talked about Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve in the non-list, in the non-Manan Biosphere Program list. We have 6 Biosphere Reserve which are not listed in Manan Biosphere Program. Dihang Dibang is one of them. So, Moling National Park is part of Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve along with Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary. So, it's basically Moling National Park and Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary which becomes Dihang Dibang बायोस्फेयर रिजर्व. इन मेघालय वी हैव नोक्रेक. नोक्रेक के बारे में हमें पता है, नोक्रेक इज अ बायोस्फेयर रिजर्व ऑल्सो. तो वंस इट्स लोकेटेड इन चेरापुंजी, सो नोक्रेक इज अ प्लेस वेयर देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ रेनफॉल दैट टेक्स प्लेस. यूनेस्को की लिस्ट ऑफ बायोस्फेयर रिजर्व में भी है ये. रेड पांडा, एलिफेंट एक्सेट्रा, सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट फौनास. देन वी हैव बल्ब हक्रम नेशनल पार्क. इट्स ऑल्सो इन मेघालय इन गारो हिल्स. एक्सट्रीम साउथ ऑफ गारो हिल्स में है. यहाँ पे भी इट्स वेरी रेनी, तो उसी तरह का वेदर कंडीशन है. मणिपुर में वी हैव केबुल लेमजाओ नेशनल पार्क. वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट केबुल लेमजाओ नेशनल पार्क ऑल्सो, जहां पे हमने डांसिंग डियर के बारे में बात करा था, संगाई डियर के बारे में बात करा था. लोकटक लेक, लोकटक लेक इज लोकेटेड हेयर. तो दिस इज वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग पार्क. यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई? लोकटक लेक पे देयर आर फुम्बीज. ऑन फुम्बीज दिस पार्क इज लोकेटेड. एंड द संगाई डियर इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डांसिंग डियर बिकॉज टू बैलेंस इटसेल्फ ऑन फुम्बीज इट हैज टू फुम्बी विच इज फ्लोटिंग इट हैज टू move around and it appears that as if they are dancing. Then there are some other national parks in northeast India. There is Murlen in Mizoram. There is Phawang Pui in Mizoram. There is Intanki in Mizoram. There is clouded leopard in Tripura. There is bison in Tripura. These are other national parks that we have in North India. ओके, सो सब याद नहीं करने हैं, बट गो थ्रू देम, रीड वंस, अंडरस्टैंड सर्टेन थिंग्स. कौन सा किस बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व का पार्ट है, कौन सा बॉर्डर पे है, दोस थिंग्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट. इट डू नॉट हैव टू लाइक आई हैव जस्ट लिस्टेड दीज अदर नेशनल पार्क्स ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया फॉर कंप्लीशन पर्पस इन द सेंस यू शुड फील लाइक कि यू शुड फील दैट इसके अलावा आपको नेशनल पार्क कहीं और से नहीं देखने. ऑल द नेशनल पार्क्स आर लिस्टेड हियर. इंपॉर्टेंट वंस हैव बीन गिवन इन मोर डिटेल. यू स्टडी देम मोर, you read them or ignore the less important ones. Okay, let me know if there are any doubts, if there are any raised hands. There's one raised hand, Chandni ji has raised hand. Chandni ji bataiye.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, you're audible, bachcha.
Sir, in Tanki is in Nagaland.
Sorry? In Tanki yes, it's Nagaland. I'm sorry. It is in Nagaland. Yes, you're right. It is in Nagaland. Nagaland ka biosphere reserve hai. Right. Thank you, Chandni. Talki is in Nagaland. Okay. Anything else, guys? Anything else? No? Okay. Then I'll see you tomorrow. Main timing batata hu. Mereko extra class leni hai. Kab mil payega mujhe class slot? And accordingly, I'll take a class, an extra class, and it would be on environment only. We'll deal with rest of the national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. Okay, thank you.